The Nigerian educational sector, since independence 60 years ago, has metamorphosed from total government control to public and private partnership, where the private sector has dominated the scene in assisting the government in terms of providing sound education to the teeming Nigerian populace. One of those private individuals who stand tall in the educational sector, giving years of service in raising excellent Nigerians who today serve in different capacities in and outside Nigeria, is Chief Mrs. Alaba Lawson, the Yalode of Yorubaland, who sits as the proprietress of the Lawson Group of Schools.
I worked at Anonzie School in Abeokuta. It's a private school in Abeokuta. From when I now went to England for my education, St. Nicholas Montessori Private School in England, 22 to 24 Prince's Gate, London Southwest 7, where I did my educational diploma. And I came out with first class with distinction in this diploma. I was the first black to come out with first class distinction, of which when they gave me my testimonial, in fact, each time I remember about testimonial and I see what I have done in Nigeria today, because they said, we will miss her at the college, but we are looking forward to what she's going to accomplish with the gifts she has with the children in Nigeria. And here I am today. For the past 43 years, I've been in education line.
She shares her experience with CEO Africa as her school clocks 43 years.
And I came back to Nigeria, I established Lawson's Child Care Nursery and Primary School in 1977, of which now today is a household name. It is not by my power, by my might, but by Jehovah's grace, of which I am grateful.
She advised government to involve stakeholders in the educational sector in the policy-making process that borders on education.
The way the policy is being run, without taking the stakeholders along, I think that is first thing. Because we were running January to December. All of a sudden, because they would now like to go to holiday here and there, and they know the summer holiday is not within the time of our own educational system, they changed our educational system from September to July. So that is number one. Number two, before they change any policy in education and before they take a decision, they should carry the stakeholders along, not only in the public school, in the private educational system.
Looking at how the educational sector has metamorphosed, she admonished the federal government to go back to revamping the educational system by encouraging the employment of grade 2 teachers and establishing more teacher training colleges and technical colleges.
I think all these teachers, crash graduate teachers, must not be used in schools. They should return back to grading of teachers. When you have grade 2 teachers, that they have to go to teaching practice, it is from the teaching practice and their theory that they will give them certificates. So let them go back to when they have teacher training colleges. That is the only way out, because they would have gone through some systems of teaching, of which they would have even practiced when they go to teaching practice. But now they will just go to university where they don't even learn how to write their names. They don't even know how to go to a class in the morning and change the dates on the blackboard. So what the hell? What you don't have, you cannot give. And all those teachers, even now, no grade 2 teachers. I would rather prefer to take a grade 2 teacher background and train her or him than just taking any graduate teacher, because they have gone through some certain challenges of teaching, of which they must have even corrected themselves if they are wrong. They should go back to the teacher training colleges, of which I will now, with this century, they should even go back to our technical colleges whereby you use your talent, use your brain in what the Lord has endowed you. These are what our forefathers that had the vision when they established the technical colleges. But along the way, no continuity, and they are in ruins now. Let us go back to the old, where we have the missing link, and fix it so that in the future, we will bequeath the best legacy for the children we are leaving behind. And now that the whole world is ICT compliance, let them now take these teachers and expose them to training. Like I said earlier, what you don't have, you cannot give. But by putting these teachers in different trainings, not just ordinary training, good training of how can I apply this? We call it presentation. If you don't have good presentation to your students, they cannot get what you are trying. But if you have good presentation, then they will easily catch up with what you are trying to teach them. So the government should wake up to their responsibility, because education is the only way that can change the whole world.
She explains that parents have their own role to play in ensuring continuity of education at the home front, so that the students do not leave what they learn in school, but work with it at home.
The education is not only in the school. It has to be a continuity at home. This is what is the missing link. You must continue at home so that all what we are teaching them in the school will be practicalized at home. Their characters must be greater than their books. And I'm telling you today, if you give a child 100% discipline, you will get 150% academic excellence. Because he or she will know when to pick her books to read. He or she will know, I have to do my work very well. Where even when they take anything home, like homework, they will do it efficiently. And that is why we must give them the morals and the discipline and the etiquette they need to grow.
The Lawson Group of Schools, which consists of creche, daycare, kindergarten, nursery, lower primary, primary, and the Royal College, has discipline, etiquette, and morals as the secret ingredients the school operates with, which gives them a competitive edge above other schools in raising excellent youths both at home and abroad. The Lawson Group of Schools has survived four decades and still waxing strong, in molding children from toddlers to adolescents to adults, and the joy of seeing them grow excellently gives untold satisfaction, as explained by the proprietress.
By the time I was in primary two, I could read. But now, apart from where the discipline is, you even see a graduate cannot write his or her name properly. They will start with the first small letter, put big letters inside, and then start writing. In fact, you must know how to write your name by the end you are in primary one and the beginning of primary two, because you are supposed to write your name on your exercise books. And so therefore, things are not the same today. When you are talking about discipline is another thing, that during our own time, we don't dare do things that is not right. When you meet our children, you will see. And by the time you look into the children from Lawson School, even those that have left, I am really proud of them. You see, and I love seeing them growing. From the daycare, you see them holding them like babies. And all of a sudden, you see them as a toddler going into the kindergarten. And when they get into the kindergarten, and then they go into the nursery, Mrs. Lawson, Nigeria Kolobe. Yes, all this. You see, and all of a sudden, Mrs. Lawson. I said, yes, I am. You see, we train them with discipline, morals, and etiquette. That is the secret behind this great school of Lawson School.
Indeed. Despite the fact that the COVID-19 pandemic has sieved the strong schools from the weak ones, as some could not survive the pang of the pandemic, the Lawson Group of Schools stands tall amidst the pandemic.
We did online and also coming to school. Even with this COVID-19, what we have done, what we did all our scheme online. But what we did it in another special way, that the teacher will come to the class and be teaching. The children will be seeing them at home, seeing them teaching. And then we give them classes. We give them their work to do, exercises. and then they send it back, and then we mark, and then they do the correction. It's a huge lot of money, but what can we do? They are at home doing nothing, and he will find work for idle hands. In fact, we now kept both the parents and the children busy, but we were successful. We were successful. So when they called us back 2 weeks ago to start schooling, we blend. So no problem at all. And all these COVID exercises, like washing your hands, like making sure you have the face masks on, before they even came, I've already done the school face masks. It was customized for nursing school. So as they are coming in, we distribute it in all the classes. And so it makes your work easier. And all other gadgets, washing hands, sanitizing. Even our chemistry students and the chemistry teacher, they were the one who did our sanitizers and our soap. And so we are even preparing some now to be put in some plastics, label it, and give it out to our parents. So you can see, these are the things that you can even make it. And I even told the chemistry teacher, not only USS3 students, please let us start it even from GSS1. Let them know what science is, and let them know we can do it ourselves. We can fix it for the future, because these are the great leaders of tomorrow, and we must let them know they can fix it themselves. Give them the structure, give them the independence, give them the opportunity that they can use it on themselves. And I know with this, they can do it.
Today, Lawson Group of Schools, situated in Abeokuta in Ogun State, is a household name to be reckoned with in the educational sector. It has passed through the test of time and waxing stronger by the day as a great citadel of learning.
To all school owners, let us do the work judiciously. And now, to all our parents, I would like you to help us work together as a team to train these children by giving them discipline, so that we can all get that missing link to bridge the communication gap that is failing in our education standard. Let us all work together and work far.